Good morning. Today we'll run about the cause of death in bird injury. Immediate cause of birth. Cause of death in bird injury. Instantaneous death or occurring within 24 hours to 48 hours of the bird. Causes are shock resulting from pain, marked loss of protein-rich fluid, hypotension, fright, toxemia, suffocation due to the inhalation of a smoke, carbon monoxide, poisonous gases like cyanide oxides of nitrogen, ammonia, hydrogen cyanide, accident or injury caused in attempt to escape from the burning site or timber falling on the body. Delayed cause. Death occurring after 5 or 6 weeks or even longer. Causes are inflammation and infection of the serous membrane and organ like meningitis, peritonitis, edema, glottitis, pleurisy, bronchitis, pneumonia or perforating ulcer. Hypoproteinemia, exhaustion from suppurative discharge, cellular damage to vital organs, complication caused by burns, pyemia, gangrene, tetanus, inhalation of toxic gases. Postmortem appearance in case of death due to bird injury. External appearance. It varies according to the nature of the substance used and the period of exposure. Burns produced by flame causes formation of blisters, singeing of hair, eyebrow. Hair become black, curl and break off easily, and the blackening of the skin. External appearance. It varies according to the nature of the substance used and the period of exposure. Burns produced by flame causes formation of blisters, singeing of hairs, eyebrow. Hair become black, curl and break off easily, and blackening of the skin. A highly heated solid body or molten metal produces a blister and the redness of a skin corresponding to the size and shape of the material used. When kept in contact for long time, it results in the roasting and charring of parts with the singeing of hair. Explosion in a coal mine or gunpowder leads to extensive burn all over the body and the blackening and tattooing of the skin. I'll repeat it again. Explosion in coal mines or gunpowder leads to extensive burn all over the body and the blackening and tattooing of the skin. Kerosene oil causes severe burn with the characteristic odor and sooty blackening and tattooing of the skin. Kerosene oil causes severe burn with the characteristic odor of the kerosene and the sooty blackening and tattooing of the skin is present. Exposure to severe heat produces clothes burns and stick to the skin. Stature and the weight of the body markedly reduced, face swollen and distorted. Cataract may be seen due to coagulation of the lens protein, tongue burnt and protruded out, cracks and fissure is present. I'll repeat it again. Exposure to severe heat produces clothes burns and stick to the skin. Stature and the weight of the body markedly reduced, face swollen and distorted. Cataract may be seen due to coagulation of lens protein, tongue burnt and protruded out, cracks and fissure is present. Pugilistic or fencing posture. The body become rigid and arched with the limb flexed, arm flexed and finger hooked due to the coagulation of muscle protein and dehydration. Position taken by the person engaged in the fight or in boxing attitude. That is the position taken by a person during fighting or during boxing. The same position is taken here also in case of death due to burn. Arms, The body becomes rigid and arched with the limb flexed at the elbow joint and the knee joint. Arm fixed and finger hooked due to coagulation of muscle protein and dehydration. Position taken by the person engaged in the fight or in boxing attitude. Flexor group of muscle has more effect than the extensor group of muscle. In case of scalds caused by boiling water, steam or ghee causes the skin is reddened with blister formation. It is dull, moist and inelastic and has dirty white look. Hair is not affected and does not blacken the skin. Blister may be present in throat and trachea. Internal appearance. If death has occurred due to intense heat, scalp bones are fractured, also called a heat fracture, or a skull burst open. These skull fractures are typically elevated due to increased intracranial pressure by the formation of steam. All skull fracture due to external injury are depressed fracture. Long bones may show curved fracture. I'll repeat it again. If death has occurred due to intense heat, the skull bones are fractured, also called as heat fracture or a skull burst open. These skull fractures are typically elevated due to increased intracranial pressure by the steam. All skull fracture due to external injury are depressed fracture. Long bones may show curved fracture. Brain and meninges are congested with the extravasation of blood on the upper surface of the dura mater called heat hematoma. It is diffused with the honeycomb appearance, soft, friable, light chocolate or pink color. Brain and meninges are congested with the extravasation of blood on the upper surface of dura mater called heat hematoma. It is diffused with the honeycomb appearance, soft, friable, light chocolate or pink color. Lungs are congested with the serous effusion into the pleural cavity. Lungs are congested with the serous effusion into the pleural cavity. Pleura may show petechial hemorrhages. Heart chambers are full of cherry red colored blood. A stomach and duodenum is reddened and more so petechy and tiny erosion. A spleen is enlarged and soft, liver show cloudy swelling, kidney may show the sign of acute tubular necrosis. Adrenals are enlarged and congested. Blood is cherry red due to carbon monoxide presence and hemoconcentration. I'll repeat it again. A spleen is enlarged and soft, liver shows cloudy swelling, kidney may show the sign of acute tubular necrosis. Adrenal glands are enlarged and congested. Blood is cherry red due to carbon monoxide presence and hemoconcentration. If death has occurred from suffocation, nasopharynx, trachea and bronchial tubes contains sooty carbon particles. If death has occurred from the suffocation, nasopharynx, trachea and bronchial tubes contains sooty carbon particle. This is the most important finding in case of antemortem burn. Their mucous membranes are congested and covered with the frothy mucus. Stomach may show sooty mucus. If death occurred due to inhalation of carbon monoxide, the changes depend on the duration of heating, intensity of heat, concentration of carboxyhemoglobin. It produces edema of the airways. Carbon monoxide level in blood is more than 10%. Blood is cherry red, which changes to brown under the influence of heat. If death occurred due to inhalation of carbon monoxide, the changes depend on the duration of heating, intensity of heat, concentration of carboxyhemoglobin. It produces edema of the airway. Carbon monoxide level in blood is more than 10%. Blood is cherry red, which changes to brown under the influence of heat. Antemortem burn features. There will be permanent lines of redness involving the whole skin around the injury part is present. Blister contains serous fluid with albumin, chloride and few WBC cells. Base is red, inflamed with the rest papilla. Surrounding skin bright red or copper color called true blister. Sign of inflammation is present, enzymatic changes is present, presence of granulation tissue and slough. Respiratory passage shows the presence of black soot or carbon soot particle. Concentration of carboxyhemoglobin is more than 10%. Postmortem burn features like permanent line of redness is absent. Blister contain air with traces of albumin and chlorides. Base is dry, hard and horny. Surrounding skin is yellow. Sign of inflammation is absent. No enzymatic changes, no such soot particle or carbon soot particle is not present. Carboxyhemoglobin is in blood is less or absent. Thank you.